I think it's because I'm the youngest that I'm such a fuck up. Who else is like the youngest of a lot of boys and just mouthy and weird? I was 10 years old, my brothers were 13 and 14, it's the 4th of July, and our parents decided, hey, we can leave our kids alone for the very first time, unsupervised. They're old enough, wrong. Our mom's bathroom was always off limits. She was always going, don't stay out of the bathroom, stay out of the bathroom. So as soon as she left, fucking A, we gotta tackle mom's bathroom, what's the fucking mystery in there? And we turn that thing inside out, and we find what we pronounce at the time, a disposable Dow-Chee. If you don't get that shit, I'm not explaining it to you, all right? Don't feel bad. We don't know what the fuck it is either, because we're squirting it on each other like it's a game. Look out for the Dow-Chee! Nothing better represents the 4th of July like a good douche water fight, right? Hell yeah. Then we hear the fireworks going on outside. So, covered in vinegar and water, we venture out to see the fireworks. Now, we were not allowed to have any fireworks for obvious reasons, but in retrospect, if they just would have given us some sparklers, none of this shit would have happened. We find this black cat firework. We try to light it. Turns out the wick is wet. Us three Einsteins say, hey, let's pour gasoline on the wick. That ought to fucking do it. You see where this is going already, don't you? My brother Brad comes running out with a full lawn mowing gasoline can right there. And he pours it on the firecracker. Right at the same time, my brother Andy decides to light a match. The flame catches the stream of the gasoline. It's shooting up to the can, and Brad's only defense from becoming some Apocalypse Now extra getting blown to fucking bits is to run away, pouring liquid fire all over the driveway to make sure the flame doesn't reach the fucking can. Oh God! Yeah, let's go around the cul-de-sac on a visual. Johnson's have sparklers. Orr's have Roman candles. Nickerson house, flaming fucking driveway. And Brad is losing the fucking battle right now, so he throws the gasoline can. Yeah, Molotov cocktail hurtled through the air in white suburbia. Boom! Our neighbors thought we were doing this shit on purpose. Our neighbors come running over. They're like, what are you kids doing over here? And we looked up to see that our mom and our stepdad had decided to come home a little early from the barbecue. They just saw all this shit unfold. They were driving like a block away to watch one of their sons just pouring fucking fire all over the driveway. Our mom takes us into the bedroom. She's pissed. I'm talking Munchausen syndrome pissed, right? Some of you get that. Some of you are like, toxic shock syndrome, what? She's yelling at us, but then she stops because she notices we forgot to put her douche away we were playing with earlier. Now, have you ever seen someone yelling at you at the top of their lungs, but they find another reason to get even more angry, but they can't yell any louder, so it just goes high-pitched? I can't believe you set the driveway on fire! What? I've been missing with my douche! When your mom points her douche at you and then breaks glass with her fucking voice, that's childhood trauma. You know where I'm coming from, right? And right when she's pointing it at us, my stepdad walks in. Yeah, what the fuck? He spent the last 10 minutes outside hosing off the driveway and apologizing to all the neighbors. He's fucking pissed. Feet stomping, door slamming. He's coming in to raise hell. But what the fuck is gonna prepare him to walk in and see his wife pointing her douche at her three children and all the fucking windows shattered out? You can see his face go from anger to extreme confusion like that. He's rewinding in his head where in the Dr. Spock manual for raising children is the chapter to use feminine hygiene products for discipline. As if to suggest, clean your room, mow the lawn, don't set the driveway on fire. That's the three kids squirt right there. That some of you moms are like, that's a good fucking idea. I should try that. Discipline your boys with the douche. If anything, it's going to be hilarious when they get married and the wife moves in and puts that on the bathroom counter to watch him go, "Ah, Dow-Chee!" The fuck is his problem? It's a 22-year practical joke. Get started.